So I started this week pretty worn out. From the very beginning, I was drained. It was just one of those weeks where everything caught up with me at once. Now the last few weeks, our family has experienced sickness, a lack of sleep, so I started off this week pretty weary. And on Monday when I woke up, I had quite a long to-do list of things that I needed to get done. And even though you start off with a list this size, it quickly grows, and there's much added to it. There was so much going on, and so much that I had to do, but I didn't have really much energy to get it all done. And I feel like I made it through this week on autopilot. Do you ever have those days, those weeks? All I wanted to do was rest, but I didn't have time to get the rest that I needed. I was sleeping, but there is a difference between sleep and rest. There was so much that I wanted to get done, but this week proved to me evermore of the need for rest. I'm sure that we all have weeks like this. We have weeks where it seems like life is just out there to get us. Weeks where there's just one difficulty after another. I'm sure that you know what I'm talking about. You've experienced it. You have times where it feels like all you're doing is jumping over hurdles, one after another, and you're just not sure how many more you're going to be able to get over. Do you have weeks where you just want to rest? Ever have those weeks where you feel like the burden you are carrying is just too heavy? That is exactly what this last week was for me. And as I was trying to get myself in the right frame of mind to study for this sermon, I came across this text from Matthew 11 where Jesus says, "Come to me, all ye who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." What a wonderful promise in Scripture for us. What a wonderful hope. Christ, our King, has promised us rest. And to be honest, we need it. And that is truly why God commands that we honor the Sabbath. In a life where we experience so many trials and hardships, where we experience so many difficulties and so much pain, life can make you weary. And we need the rest that God promises us, because we don't often get it on our own. We need to reach out to Him. Now, I know for some of us, rest might seem like a waste of time. Most of us have a difficult time imagining a day devoted to rest. You see, we admire people who work hard. We have long to-do lists, family responsibilities, we have obligations, work responsibilities, ministry responsibilities, hobbies, and the list goes on. And for many of us, there is too much to do and too very little time to get it all done. And I'm sure that sometimes we feel the stress of busyness. You know, we need a break. And we say that we should stop and have a break and smell the roses, as the saying goes. But for some of us, there never seems to be enough time for rest. We try to budget our time. We try to distinguish between quality time and regular time. But too often, we know the consequences of such stress as well. High blood pressure, heart attacks, broken relationships, sleep deprivation, poor eating habits, and the list goes on. Yet even knowing these things, hearing that we ought or should try to take a break simply gives us one more thing to squeeze into our schedule. We often find ourselves taking on too much. So how can we rest? In Exodus 28:11, we read, "Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you nor your son or daughter, nor your male or female servant, nor your animals, nor your any foreigner residing in your towns. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them, but he rested on the seventh day. Therefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. And you see that God uses this particular portion of Scripture, these commands, in several books. We read it from Deuteronomy as our passage this morning, but it's also in Exodus for us as well. God taught us how to manage our time by resting, even though he didn't need to. The Bible teaches us that the rest is an important part of our lives, no matter what we are doing. We find in the Scriptures that rest comes from God. Rest is for us, and rest is for God. Now, rest comes from God. One of the first truths we see about rest is that it comes from God. In Exodus, we read. In Deuteronomy, we read that God created everything in 6 days and rested on the seventh. And this is the same thought found in Genesis 2, 1-3, which says, "Thus the heavens and the earth were compiled in all their vast array. By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing, so on the seventh day he rested from all his work. Then God blessed the seventh day and made it holy, because on it he rested from all the work of creating that he had done." God rested. A God who never sleeps, who is all-powerful and ever-present, takes the day off. And because God rested, God directs his people to rest. The word Sabbath comes from the Hebrew verb for he rested. The God that we believe in is not one that needs any sort of rest at any time. Yet the Bible is clear that when he was setting the foundations of the world, that on the seventh day he rested. He did this to show us a pattern of what is needed in our own lives. God set a pattern of work and rest from the very beginning of creation. God created work. God created rest. Rest is from God. He created a Sabbath for us. Now we read also that rest is for us and for those around us. And Jesus Christ tells us in Mark 2:27, "The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath." The Message puts it like this: the Sabbath was made to serve us. We weren't made to serve the Sabbath. Rest was designed for us to calm down, to center our emotions, to be refreshed, and to physically rest our bodies. Human beings were not fashioned by God to work constantly, all day, every day, with no relief and no break. Jesus tells us that rest was made for us because we need rest. God set the pattern of rest for us, for our benefit. And regularly practicing Sabbath provides us with a time of rest, physically, mentally, and spiritually. Sabbath is a gift from God, a beneficial gift. Leonard Sweet says, "It's not so much that we keep the Sabbath, as that the Sabbath keeps us whole, keeps us sane, keeps us spiritually alive." Genuine Sabbath keeping is not a series of you shall nots, but a string of celebrations. Its goal is not to shut you off from the realities of life, but to open you up to living. As Christians, as parents, as grandparents, we need to model Sabbath practices of corporate worship, of shared fellowship, of refreshing prayer times, and rest. You see, rest is not only for us, but for those around us. When you get into the habit of Sabbath, those around you also benefit. Your family will benefit from the priority of rest because each member of the family is resting. Your children, your grandchildren, will learn that Sabbath is a normal part of life. And they will learn to enjoy and practice Sabbath rest. What kind of rest do you need? Do you need social rest, spending quality time with family, with friends? Do you need a mental rest? Moving away from phones, the telephone, other things that force our minds to be busy, and to just do something simple that allows your mind to rest? Do you need physical rest? Do you need to slow down, to breathe, to take a nap? Do you need spiritual rest? Do you need to regularly attend worship services and to allow the Holy Spirit to speak into your life and to grow you? I would suggest that resting involves all of these things. And learning to Sabbath means you rest your mind, you rest your body, and you engage your spirit. And that leads us to the last truth this morning, that rest is for us, for God. Above all the other reasons, rest was built into the pattern of our lives because it is a time for us to stop and to focus on God. To fulfill the biblical view of Sabbath, we must stop our busy lives and all the things that we would normally do and focus our attention on God. To focus our attention on our relationship with Jesus, who so often gets crowded out in all the coming and going and activities of life. You see, rest is more than just the physical body or our emotions, but rest is for our spiritual life as well. Remember the passage that we read from Deuteronomy. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. In verse 11 we read, "For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth." God did everything in 6 days, but on the seventh day he rested. God built into our lives a day to rest and remember him. God desires that we take a day out of our busy lives and rest and focus on him. It is on this day of rest that we make an effort to be still. And in Psalm 46 and 10, we read, "Be still and know that I am God." It is on this day of rest that we focus on our relationship with him. The daily spiritual discipline of Sabbath is about taking time to put God first, but opening our minds, our bodies, and our spirits to his path for our lives. Daily Sabbath means we need to find a few minutes each day to breathe in God. In this breath, we slow down not only our bodies, but also our minds. And in slowing down both body and mind, we are able to open our spirits to God and his direction for our lives. But to be effective, Sabbath needs to be practiced daily as well as weekly. The daily practice of Sabbath must be intentional. And as busy people, finding time to breathe in God daily is not always easy. As faithful Christians, I'm sure that we're aware of the presence of God in every day, in everything that we do. But daily Sabbath is more than awareness of God. It is a practice that centers our lives and creates a deeper relationship with him. Daily Sabbath is enhanced when the spiritual discipline of weekly Sabbath is practiced. Weekly Sabbath, it's what we're doing here today. We're setting aside one day a week that belongs to God. A day that reminds us of the love Christ demonstrated on the cross for us and the power of the resurrection. So what should Sabbath look like? And I've often asked that question myself. But here are some things to exclude from Sabbath time, things that we shouldn't be doing during our Sabbath time with God. We should exclude work, anything that constitutes work for us. Now, if somebody loves to garden and finds peace and calm in that, then that's not work. That's something that you can use to bring yourself closer to God. We shouldn't be buying and selling on the Sabbath. Worry. This creates emotional and mental work. So we should exclude worry from our Sabbath time. How easy is that? For some, it's not. But what should we include in Sabbath time? We should include a time of resting the body. For some, it may be a walk. For some, it may be listening to music. For some, it may be taking a nap, because that's what we need sometimes, resting the body. It even could be eating your favorite foods. Now, maybe that's not always healthy, but it's resting the body. We should spend time replenishing the spirit, reading a book, talking with loved ones. We should spend time restoring our souls in worship and quiet reflection, in silence and prayer, and worship in community. I know that we live in a fast-paced, go, go, go culture. And we sometimes find it difficult to slow down and to rest. But this way of living is very dangerous for us. Wayne Mueller, in his book called Sabbath, said that if we do not allow for a rhythm of rest in our overly busy lives, illness becomes our Sabbath. Our pneumonia, our cancer, our heart attack, our accidents create Sabbath for us. It forces us to slow down and rest. Is it really that hard for God to get our attention? No one is beyond needing a rest. And the truth is that we all die. Regardless of how we spend our time, when we die, we will leave behind unfolded laundry, unchecked items on our to-do list, unkept appointments on our calendars. Our business will never be finished. But a Sabbath rest gives us a chance to become conscious of the eternity in our time, to live mindful of the presence of God. Our time here is too precious not to take a Sabbath and to rest in Him. Jesus said in Matthew 11, "Come to me, all who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." Rest is more than sleep. It is a slower pace of life that is focused on God. A Sabbath represents downtime that our bodies truly need and deserve. Sabbath is about deciding not to push ourselves to the limit, but rather surrounding ourselves with the presence of God. The spiritual discipline of Sabbath, practiced daily and weekly, is an act of faith that leads to a deeper personal and corporate relationship with God. How and when we practice this discipline is a personal choice. But no matter what the choice, if carried out faithfully, it will lead to a rhythm of life that can begin to bring us into an alignment with the Spirit of God. I don't know about you and how you spend Sabbath time. Maybe for some of you, your Sabbath is just here on Sundays, coming together and worshiping with one another, fellowshipping with one another. But Sabbath time also causes us to come into a personal time with God on our own, not just corporately. Sabbath rest is about building our relationship with our Heavenly Father. And there are many times that we need to take that time of rest. This week, I'm not sure what you've had to face. There may have been many struggles, many trials that have come upon you. And I don't know how you've dealt with those, how you're continuing to deal with those, but I pray that you've spent some time in Sabbath rest with your Heavenly Father to help you cope and to deal with things that you may have had to face. We're going to sing a chorus this morning that says, "Lord, take me again to the house of the potter. Mold me and make me and shape me, I pray. Jesus, remove every flaw from this vessel and make me a vessel of honor today." Do you need to come and spend some quality time with the potter this morning? Do you need to spend some time in Sabbath rest, to wait upon him for a word of encouragement or comfort. I pray that as we sing this morning, that you will allow his Holy Spirit to speak to you, that you will allow him to mold you and to shape you and to make you into a follower, a faithful follower, to a Christian that can go out into this world and to show his love. May he draw you into a closer communion with him this morning. May you rest in him as we sing and reflect. Let's sing that chorus together. Lord, take